Hey, John Sanmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got a question here from Tyler. And Tyler says, thanks for the follow on Twitter and again for publishing your book and answering some of my questions in the past. I totally missed that video from back in 2013. I didn't know you followed Mr. Money Mustache. I'm a huge fan of his. So I think Tyler's referring to, I don't know what video he's referring to, but I've mentioned a couple of times Mr. Money Mustache, which is pretty interesting guy who I follow. You can check it out, do a Google for Mr. Money Mustache, and I'll probably put a link down below. But he's a guy that retired like at, I think it was like 30 or something, and he was just a regular dude who just, you know, decided he was going to live frugally. He lives on like, or he was living on like $28,000 a year, his whole family, and he figured out he could make enough money to retire on that, and he was way happier in life doing that than being a slave to a corporate job his whole life. So anyway, so Tyler goes on to say, my question, as a younger, 26, designer slash dev, when I first started out in my career, I loved what I did. After hearing it and being inspired by you and Mr. Money Mustache, I realized I no longer need to work. If I can get my monthly expenses lower than my passive cash flow, real estate and investing, now my focus has swung from being a better designer or developer to learning about real estate slash investing. Instead of reading programming books like Clean Code, I find myself reading books like Millionaire Real Estate Investor. Is this okay? Will I lower my earning potential because I'm not focusing on the right thing? Thanks, Tyler. So, Tyler, I think you are focusing on the right thing. I mean, in the long term, understanding how to invest and understanding some of these other concepts in life is going to be more beneficial than learning the new version of C# or JavaScript. In the short term, learning C# and JavaScript, you're going to need to know that for your career. But, you know, and I'm going to give you different advice than I would give someone else, because you clearly are someone who wants to retire early, who values their time more than just money itself. So, you know, in general, I think I would give young software developers the advice of, you know, really investing heavily in their career, learning technologies, marketing themselves, etc. But that's looking at like a 30-year career time span. But if you're looking at like how quickly can you get out of the rat race, what's the quickest you can do that, then I've got a little bit different advice for you. So I would say basically that you are on the right path, but what you're going to need to do is basically put more of your time and effort into what you're already doing as far as learning real estate and other investment to be able to generate passive income. You're on the right road for lowering your expenses as much as possible. This is something that I always stress to people and they don't quite get it. When you lower your monthly expenses, you double your effectiveness to reaching retirement. Because if you require less money to live off of, then not only do you save more money, which puts you quicker to buying the investments that will give you passive income to help you retire, but it also means that you need less income to retire. So it's on both sides here. You know, if your expenses were $10,000 a month and you reduce it to $5,000 a month, not only are you saving $5,000 more a month, but now, instead of needing $10,000 a month to retire, you only need $5,000. So you need half as much, and you're saving it twice as fast. So good. Do that. Keep doing that. The other thing I would say is that, you know, if you have a job as a software developer or designer, and you're making decent money, you can invest in trying to make a lot more money. But if your time span is like 5 to 10 years, if you're actually trying to basically, you know, retire young and early, then your time is going to be better spent on figuring out how to invest the money and turn it to passive income, because you're never going to, that investment in your technical abilities is not going to translate enough into a high enough pay. So, you know, just let's use some concrete numbers here. Let's say you're making $80,000 a year salary. You might invest in your technical skills and over the next 5 years go up to $100,000 a year. that's, it's going to require a lot of time to do that. It would be better to invest that time into learning how to generate passive income, which will be more towards your goal. If you're cutting your expenses way down, if you're trying to get out of the rat race as soon as possible, to me, that makes more sense. So I think you're on the right track. You obviously have to keep your skills up. You know, like I said, I'm giving you totally different advice than I would give most young software developers, because I would tell them to basically, like, you know, keep on increasing their abilities and their skills in the field so that they'll become more valuable, and that's going to pay off in the long run. But instead, I would tell you, just be in maintenance mode. Make sure that you have enough applicable skills to do your job and continue getting paid and keep your job, and then devote the rest of your time into developing the skills to be able to build passive income and to be able to retire early to invest, because that's going to be the thing that's going to be much more valuable to you over the long run. So, good question. I like the path that you're taking. But I wish more people would take that path. But like I said, you know, the number one thing is going to be what you already sounds like you're doing is reducing your expenses. If you're following the Mr. Mustache route, I think you'll get there. But yeah, don't worry too much about investing your time in the education that's going to help you to retire early. But I would also say, make sure you do take action. A lot of people read, they read all these books, and then they never actually do anything. And again, you know, you could be the wisest investor in the world, but if you've never actually done anything, it's not going to matter. So anyway, thanks for sending me this email. I hope that you've enjoyed the answer. And if you liked this video, definitely subscribe to my channel, and I will talk to you next time. Take care.